Welcome to an example on how to determine the function rule for a piecewise defined function given the graph of the function. The first thing we should notice is the graph has three pieces, therefore our piecewise defined function will have to have three separate function rules. We'll have a function rule for this piece, which will be our first function rule. Then we'll have a function rule for the second piece, which will be our second function rule. And then for the third piece, we'll have a third function rule. This is a nice example to begin with because each piece is a constant function, meaning each piece is a horizontal segment. Remember, all horizontal lines are in the form of y equals some constant, or in this case, f of x equals a constant. So we'll define the function rule for each piece, and then we'll define the domain or the x values for each piece. So if we start with this blue piece, notice that we would have the equation y equals negative 3, or in this case, f of x equals negative 3. But notice this is only true on the interval between negative 4 and negative 1, where it does not include negative 4, but it does include negative 1. So f of x equals negative 3 if x is greater than negative 4, and less than or equal to negative 1. This would be the domain or the interval for x when f of x equals negative 3. Now looking at the green piece, notice how we'd have the function y equals negative 1 or f of x equals negative 1. And the interval for this piece is from negative 1 to positive 2. Notice how it does not include either endpoint. That's why we have open points on each end. So the interval is going to be when x is greater than negative 1 and less than positive 2. This is the interval for which f of x equals negative 1. And then for the last piece, the yellow piece, notice how this would be the function y equals 2 or f of x equals 2. So there's our function rule. And this is a rule only on the interval from positive 2 to positive 4. But in this case, we do include both endpoints. So the interval or domain for this piece would be x is greater than or equal to positive 2 and less than or equal to positive 4. We'll take a look at another example in the next video where the function rules are not so basic or not just constant functions. But this is a nice example to begin with to practice defining the domains or intervals for x for each function rule. I hope you found this helpful.